Today I will do a demonstration for figure drawing, since this is for preparation for the online teaching. We don't have model at home, so I will use a photo, and students are going to use a photo to do the practice of the figure drawing. Yeah, this is an unusual situation that we have to do our practice. Everyone at home. So, yeah, using the photo, it's a little bit awkward. As the purpose of the figure drawing is to try to catch the three-dimensional life model image. Drawing that on our 2D paper, but if we use the image of a photo, it's really doesn't make sense. It's already compressed into a 2D image, so it's a little bit like cheating. However, we just assume we are looking at the model to do our drawing. It's helpful. It might be helpful for the study, so it's just for study. Let me select one photo. I use a 2B pencil, I do a little bit of big one. It's more than just a sketch, however, the whole process will include the beginning part of the sketch, and then a little more detail. They are not really a certain format for like 2 minutes or 5 minutes, how much you needed to do, like 10 minutes you needed to do, there's no certain format. The much you can do, the better. Sometimes 5 minutes, it can do a lot. So when I do this demonstration, of course when I talk, it's a little bit slower than the usual practice. So at the very beginning, we do the gesture line. Maybe because I'm using the pencil, it's a little bit. Maybe next time I try to use the pastel again. Last time I did pastel for the tree drawing. Maybe next time we try again. So I do use a pencil. So, there's a pencil, maybe a bit too light for the lens, but just try to see. The very beginning, we use a gesture line. Usually the gesture line helps to find this tendency, like two arms, what's that tendency, two shoulders, what's the tendency. The pelvis, what's the tendency? Maybe when I hit it here, it's not necessarily accurate. But for a sketch, when you're small size, it's more easy to catch. And the larger size, sometimes a little, at the very beginning, maybe not so much accurate. So this is the gesture line. And usually we start from the middle. So this is the pelvis area, the pelvis. So when we draw the pelvis, we can do it like a box. In this case, we see the back side of the box. Actual situation, the real pelvis is a little smaller, if not including the hip. A little smaller shape like this. And then jar, the rib cage, one the rib cage. You just see the difference between the rib cage and the pelvis. So in this case, the pelvis has a little more fat side. The rib cage is a little more side. So it's a little bit twisted. And also you see the angle between the rib cage and the pelvis. You see the angle. You see this. It's a bending and a little bit twisted. And also a little bit tipping. And this part you can see it is shifting. So you see this relation for ribcage and pelvis. Okay, so it's interesting. Actually this part is higher, but because she lift the arm up, so this arm a little bit lower. So two arms like this situation. It's against. So actually the rib cage direction is like this. It's like this. So okay, then you can see her neck. It's a C7. C7. And you can see the neck and the rib cage has a little bit angled. Not necessarily go up like this, but let's go this way. So you see the neck. Sometimes it's easier to tell the perspective situation using this circle line. You can feel it's going that way. Then the head. So first you can see the cranium part is like this. Cranium part. And then the facial part. Facial. The ear is here. Twisted, the neck and the head twist. Okay. Yeah, this shoulder is lower actually. It is too high. Lower. Rib cage look like this. Yeah. Don't do the rib cage too big, usually like 1.5 is enough. Many people do the rib cage very big as well. Here's the pelvis. Either do a box or do a more like a triangle. See, that is for pelvis. Pelvis and then this part is the greater trochanter. This part with the thigh part. tape. Knee part, this is the back side, knee part, joint, and then the cave. When we draw the cave, we need to see it's a triangle there, like a poem. Also look like corn, triangular. See, you can see the ankle, some higher and lower. And then the heel. And then jaw. Foot. Okay, so now we can... Draw the breast. Front. Skip here. Skip here. The spine. Then we can draw the shoulder and the elbow. So when you draw the elbow, you see the shape of the whole profile of the forearms. The forearms here is more triangular. I have the line, sorry, stick. This way. Draw one part. Hand. Another one, other side, shoulder, this way, shoulder, arm, and this part when we draw the forearm, you can see this look like a plug into the forearm. Then the hand. To do this much more accurate. Much more accurate for the back side. Yeah, for like 2 minutes, if you draw fast, a small size, like this, it's okay. For 5 minutes, you can do a little more detail. A little more detail, you can see the facial a little bit. here. Features, make sure the perspective feeling. Let's go look down. Now I'm going to do a little more shading. Now, of course, based on the photo, it's cheating. Based on the photo, do some shading. So the lights go this way, and this arm is in the shades. You do like a 10 minutes one, you can do a little bit of shading like this. A little bit details, hairs. And sometimes you need outline this bony part so that make it more structurally. More solid looking to work. I'll do a little more contrast on the front arm because it's more towards you. So you can draw a little bit detail. The bone, a little bit shaping, not just the based on lighting function, but based on the structure. So sometimes shading and the curve line is necessary to have a little bit curve line. If you like the structure, it's more accurate. So draw the finger. You can see more shading on the back side. A little bit curved line. Let's see. Folds. actually input here. Which other lines? You need to compare each other. So this line more solid, and this much more forward, backward line can be a little more softer. Yeah. Don't have to erase this. Don't have to a little bit. It's okay. Don't have to. You can keep that. So this part you can a little bit erase it once it's finished. All right, so this is finished. So I will photo some other sketches I just did on this video together. I didn't videotape the process, but that's it. You can combine the stuffs together, so you maybe have more idea about how to do the shorter time sketch. Okay. So this is a little bit shorter time than the one I just did. The process is the same, but less hatching. You can see the line for the structures. I consider this is like a 5 minute sketch, and another piece is for like 2 minutes, more faster. So like this one, I directly outline, not actually the structural drawing inside, but this one I had a more, but it's more rapid, faster drawing. This is considered 2 or 3 minutes, and this one is the larger size, 5 minutes to 7 or 8 minutes, and the current one is more like 10 minutes to 50 minutes. All right, so that's it. Thank you.